In this video, we will show you how to create a template from your very own idea and use the Algo wizard to create it in StrategyQuant to speed up the building process. I personally find this functionality to be the absolute best in StrategyQuant because with this functionality, you are able to build strategies efficiently and quickly and also measure your success in a given workflow. So let's take a look right into the chart and let's explain the simple idea. The goal of this template is not to completely get the most profitable, best combination, but to show you the process to be able to transform a simple idea right into a StrategyQuant using Algo Wizard feature. So I've got a chart of the Nasdaq here on an hourly time frame. I've got a moving average set up here with a period of 200. And I've got a CCI indicator here with a period of 24. But later on, just in StrategyQuant, I will show you how to set the ranges for each indicator so that StrategyQuant finds the most optimal variations. We are going to look for a signal when we are in an uptrend, meaning the close is greater than the moving average with a period of 200, or arbitrarily different. That will be the signal for long, and the signal for short will be when the close is less or lower than the moving average. This will ensure that we are always looking in that particular trend. And then here comes the second CCI indicator, and we are going to be looking within the uptrend. We are going to be entering in some downtrend of that uptrend or in the oversold portion within the downtrend. Here's kind of a sample long signal. We would enter somewhere around here and exit with a stop loss or take profit. So let's show you how to put such an idea directly into StrategyQuant. I've got a sample strategy that I've just prepared here, but we are going to show how to create such a whole strategy from scratch and create it just using the template system. As we can see, this strategy is profitable. The result is not much, but the goal now is not to create the best strategy, but I show you how to create such a simple idea in Algo Wizard and StrategyQuant. If we run the whole backtest, the full backtest, StrategyQuant will show us the results of the strategy. The backtest, of course, takes so much time depending on how many trades there are and what time frame and precision is used in the backtest. Now the backtest is over and we can see that the strategy is doing more than 4,000 trades. That result is not great, but let's try to transform the strategy into a template and let's try to find the best parameters and possibly some other conditions. We will create a template based on that strategy logic. So click on New, click on Full Editor, and we can call it, let's say, CCI template. I've created the basic structure of the strategy, and now what I need to do right away is switch the strategy into templating mode. I have to note here that strategy template mode is lit, and please know that you cannot backtest the template in this mode. It can only be used in Builder, but we will see that later. So we have a basic structure, and I do recommend starting from the left side, so from close. So find close and we find moving average for the right side. Let's add a moving average. And here I can choose directly the range of the parameter. I recommend not to choose the parameters to be too high, but always choose a specific range so that the build is faster. And also set the ranges like logically and not completely in too wide range. This will ensure more efficient optimization. For example, give a period of 100 to 300, but with a step of 10. So it will be this parameter that we will optimize. Now we will add a condition for the CCI. Either greater than minus 200 or greater than 100. We will look up number value and set it to minus 200. but we can also set a specific range right here. For example, from minus 150 to, let's say, minus 300 with a step of minus 10. So we'll put in number value, and now we'll set the other side of the CCI. Here we will want to look for a specific period. We are going to specify three values: start, stop, and step. Again, here we will put, for example, 10 up to a value of 100 with a step of 10. We will turn the sign around here again and add a value of equal. This means that if the CCI with a certain period is greater than or equal to minus values, and the condition that the close is greater than the moving average is also met, then we will buy. If we want to do this for short as well, we will just reverse the condition. We will find the close again, change the condition to is lower than, so the close is lower than the moving average, and then enter the short. Again, we will set the moving average to 100, from 100 to 300, with a step of 10. We will add a number value, set a value for step, for example, 100 to 300 with a step of 10. We will set is greater or equal. Now, add a CCI value to the right-hand side, just like the other CCI. So a value of 10 to 100 with a step of 10. Now we will double check this according to the original idea. And it looks like everything is correct. Now let's take a look at the outputs. For simplicity, we will turn on profit target and stop loss as default, which means they will always be determined by the builder. We will use the same settings for the trailing stop and TS activation level. And we will set the same for shorts. If we go over this one more time, when the close is greater than the moving average, it will serve as a trend filter. And when the CCI is greater than or equal to minus 150, it will enter a long position and it will enter behind the market position. And vice versa, we will enter a short position. That means we'll be looking for overbought areas within a given trend. I save the template. I call it, let's say, CCI template 2. Now I click on create a new custom project and call it CCI template. Now I click on add new task, and I will take the settings here from Forex, for example. So we are going to build for Nasdaq with a RoboForex profile, and we will choose that we want to build from the template. Here we will select the template that we want to choose. For simplicity, we will build using fixed pips. Stop loss with a range of 300 to 1000 pips. We set the same for profit target, just with slightly higher values, to build strategies with a positive risk-reward ratio. We have set the market. We choose in sample because we only want to use data from that section. We set tick data. And for a quick demonstration, we will set the period from 2017 to 2022. With 50% being the first out of sample. I always recommend keeping some data to validate the strategy later. We are going to go out on Friday at 8:40 p.m. We have selected specific blocks, but in this case, only the optimized values will be used. We use a fixed money management of 0.1 lots, which does not play a role in this case. And we will turn off the higher precision cross check and set all values to in sample so we don't look into the future. For simplicity, we will turn off all automatic filters. We have set 1000 strategies and we can add a condition that we want to receive strategies that have at least 50 trades in out of sample, for example. This way, we won't be evaluating strategies in out of sample, but all we care about is receiving a statistically significant number of trades in out of sample. The setup is done, and we can click on Start button. We will wait a moment, and we will see the results in a moment or in just a few seconds. The first strategies are in the data bank. I'm going to take a look at them, and since the backtest on 1 minute data can take longer, you will see how the strategies behave with a high number of trades. If we line it up, we can see that the strategy was trained on this data and validated on this data. If we add another test, we can retest them on completely unused data. Now we look that one up in the source code, where we can see in the pseudocode that the strategy trades according to our requirements. Now we could possibly continue to refine it. If we look at the specific results directly in AlgoWizard on the chart, we highlight the strategy, click on Tools, and edit a strategy. The strategy will be sent directly to AlgoWizard, where we can backtest and view the results directly on the chart. We click on Trading Options and Stored Chart Data, and then select Full Backtest. We can see that this backtest shows complete historical data and we can reset the values for the entire history. This way, we can backtest how the strategy performed on the full data. We can see that the strategy is profitable even on the complete data. It had a minor dip before 2017, but the long-term curve is profitable. There is now an opportunity to improve the strategy as it makes quite a lot of trades, which means there is a lot of room for improvements and for adding filters. However, from experience, the more complicated the strategy, the more strategy tends to be overfitted. And that's it for this video. If you have any questions, please drop us a line in the comment section, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Goodbye.